Hello, welcome to Arvind Singh Academy. We are going to discuss today another tricks and techniques to find a square root of numbers which is in decimal form. One day, I asked in my class to the students, there were almost 800 students in my class and I was taking classes for CSAT. And I asked one question, that what is the square root of 0.9? I become very surprised when only 2 or 3 students are able to answer the question. Although there are almost, I hope, it is not exactly calculated, but out of 800, more than 500 students are engineers. Remaining 100 more students have backgrounds of mathematics, whether they are from graduate in mathematics or they did till 12th in mathematics. But still, this simple question they have not able to answer the question. This compels me to give an idea how to find the square root of number in quick seconds that I am going to discuss here. And I want to share it before you. So how to find a square root of decimal numbers? Usually in long division method, when you have to find the square root of numbers, suppose someone has to find the square root of 120, then they are making the pair from this side. Right side we are making the pairs. Right now? From right side we are making the pairs, suppose 3, 5, 7, 9, 1, then we have to make pair of the numbers. And then we think about what is the number whose square would be 13 or less than 13. But here I am not going to discuss this one. I am going to discuss the small way to find the square root of numbers related to decimals. For example, suppose someone has to find the square root of 0.3. What to do? Or 0.9, like this. Whenever I ask a square root of 0.9, will you tell me what will be the answer? Many students have replied me the answer that 0.3. Some of them have replied the answer as 0.003. Some of them replied 0.03. But none of them is correct. If I took a square root of a number, let me introduce what is a square root. A square root of a number is a number which multiply itself give the original number. So if someone say the square root of 0.9 is 0.3, then what is meaning of this? 0.3 cannot be, because 0.3 multiplied by 0.3 would be 3 3 is 9, and after decimal there would be 20. That is 0.09, not 0.9. So that is why this cannot be answered. 0.3 means 3 by 10. If I remove the point, that is also 3 by 10. 9 by 100, and 9 by 100 is nothing else but 0.09. So what to do and how can you find the answers in quick calculations? To find the answer of such questions, up to at least 2 place of decimal, you have an idea in which you can deal with. Make the numbers pairs from left side after decimals, that is 90. If there is only one number, we can make it 90. And now we will think about the square root of 90. Don't forget about decimals. Just go for 90. What will be the square root of 90? To calculate the square root of 90, we can imagine that 81, square root of 81 is 9, square root of 100 is 10, and this number is 90. So a square root of 90 lies between 9 and 10. If suppose someone has to find the square root of 90, then it would be between 9 to 10. And what will be that? How can you know that what will be between 9 to 10? There will be several numbers. How can you recognize what will be the exact number after 9 and 10? So what is the difference? Try to understand. Difference is 9. Here the difference is 10. Difference from what? Difference from 81. If I took 90, Then difference from 81 is 9. Difference from 100 is 10. So a square root of 90 lies between. This is almost half, slightly lesser this side. So it will be slightly lesser than 9.50. Slightly lesser than 9.50 means 9.4 something. You can 9.50 slightly lesser than 9.50. One can write 9.48. If you are so perfect in imagination, you can write 9.48, or someone may write 9.47 even. But one thing is clear, that if there was 90, a square root would be 9.48. But we have 0.9, so decimal place shifted to here, and what will be the answer? 0.948. Three place of decimals, up to three place of decimals, it can be observed accurate. But even though, if you are not so quick, you can judge at least 2 points of decimals accurately. Let us consider another example. If I am going to find out a square root of 30, what will happen? A square root of 30 is lies between 25 and 36. 5 square is, a square root of 25 is 5. A square root of 36 is 6. 30 is lying between this. So a square root of 30 would be somehow between 5 and 6. How much different? 5. What is less? 6. Again, this is in similar pattern. Slightly lesser than the half this side. So it would be 5.48, say, like this. 5.48 I can write here. And 5.48 is the square root of 30. Slightly lesser than 5.50. 5.50, lesser than 5.50. You can imagine 5.48, 5.49, 5.47. But 5.4 is sure, you know. 5.4 is sure, na? So up to two place of decimals you can derive. Or even 5.47 you can write, it will not make a big difference in it. But 5.48 would be the appropriate answer. Suppose if this is 0.3, then I can write 0.548. This is what my purpose today, that if there is any number which is lies between 0.2, suppose someone has to write a square root of 0.2, how can you deal with? Make the pair of number, consider it like 20. If the number was 20, think about this, then it is greater than 16 and less than 25. If it was 16, then the square root of 16 would be 4. If it was 25, the square root of that is 5. So this must lie between, a square root of 20 must lie between 4 and 5. What to do? You can think about this. This is 4 more and 5 less. So of course, this is 4 point something lesser than 5. I have another idea to find the accuracy in which you can find up to accurate digit. For example, what is the difference between these two? 4 and 5, that is 1. And what is this difference? 4 and 5, 9. 1 can be divided by 9 segment. 9 segment, because this is in ratio of 4 is to 5. Although, in oral calculation, one can simply say 4.45 is the right answer. 4.44 is the right answer. You can write it. 4.45 approximate or 4.44. But how to deal with this? 4.44 is the right answer of a square root of 20. But here, if you can write 0.20, then what would be the answer? 0.444. And that will be the answer. Point will be shifted to one place left. So in that way, any square root can be calculated. But if you want to go for accuracy, there is another idea. 1 can be divided into 9 parts, 4 is to 5 ratio, because the marginal difference between 4 and 5 is 1. So that 1 can be divided into 9 parts. If you divide 1 by 9 parts, 1 by into 9, what is that? 0.11, right? 0.11. And this is 4 part. So 4 part must be 0.11 multiplied by 4 is 0.44. So what is the sale of this out of 4? 0.44, and therefore we can analyze the accurate answers very quickly to find it. Let me consider one more example. Suppose I have to consider the 60, a square root of 60. What to do? How to deal with? If it was 64, it is more than 8 square and less than 9 square. So more than 7 square and less than 8 square. That is more than 49 and less than 64. So it is more than 49, right? So, and less than 64. If it was 49, then it would be 7. If it was 64, then the square root of that would be 8. But it is 60. So what will be the square root of this? Let me explain this. 60, 64. How much more? 11 more. How much less? 4 less. This is 4:3, almost 1:3. Or even you can divide it in 15 part. 11 plus 4 is 15 part. Or you can write in simplest form 4 and 11 can be written as 1:3. But if you want to divide in 15 part, 1 divided by 15 is 0.6. Right? 0.66. And now 4 part would be what? 4 part this side, it will be less than 8 or more than 7. So 7 into 0.66 into 11 is 6.74 almost, right? So 0.6 is into 11 times or 4 into 6 times. Either you can subtract from 8 or you can add from 7. 0.11 into 11 times of 0.66 is 0.7. And 6.76, you know, 0.76, 11, 6, 66, carry 6, 11, 6, 66, and 6, 72. So 0.726, that would be 7.726 is the square root of 60. That can be written up to 3 place of decimal, but this is uncertain. Might be this is uncertain, but at least 2 digits surely will be certain digit. And if someone has to find the square root of 0.6, then they can easily write 0.7726 without doing anything. So for doing all those things, you need to learn squares of numbers, few numbers, and thereafter you can calculate it. For example, suppose someone has to calculate a square root of 120. It is slightly less than, if 11 square is 121, it is slightly less than 121 and more than 100, right? So, 20 more than 100, 1 less than 100, that is 21 parts, the whole segment can be divided, and that is approximately 5. So, what will be the square root of that? 0.05 less, that is 10.95 is the answer of this square root. And therefore, we can write like this, and hopefully, you will do that, and you will get it. Whenever you have to find the square root of any number, you will do this. For example, suppose the square root of 0.5, you can write easily that it is more than 0.7. Clear? It is more than 7 point something, 0.7 something. A clear answer. Suppose someone has to find 0.8, what will be that? Clearly, it is less than 0.9. Because if it is 81, if it would be 81, the square root of that would be 0.9. But it is lesser than 81, slightly lesser than 81, so it is obviously slightly lesser than 0.9, means you can write 0.89, that would be the answer. So in that way, you can write the square root of any decimal numbers quickly, fastly, or even numbers are not in decimal form, like 120, 60, or 90 or 81 or 85 or 80-30, like this, all these numbers can be calculated quickly without using the proper long division method by this shortcut ideas. I hope you got this and you will be able to use it. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please watch and subscribe our video to get regular update. We have many shortcut tricks to calculate and for speed up your calculation. So please subscribe our channel and be in regular touch. Thank you very much.